Don't mind me. I'm just creeping. What's going on, everyone? Josh is the name, Magnitude is the channel, and let's talk money. I don't know if you could tell by the way I was creeping, but today we're talking about lifestyle creep. There's a reason I talk so much about frugality on my channel. It's because there's no correlation between income and wealth. When most of us get a raise, we start to spend more money. This is called lifestyle creep. It's where, as we grow our income, we start to spend more money on those things that we used to consider luxuries. We feel that it is now our right to enjoy these things because, you know, we've earned it. I remember when I got my first job after college, I thought I was rolling in the dough at $32,500 per year. It was more than I had ever been earning in my life up to that point at that time, and I felt like I could afford anything. I had been very responsible with my credit card during college. I paid it off every month, but once I was making good money, I started buying things without having the money in the bank. I would think to myself, I'll have the money by next paycheck, so I'll just pay it off then. That turned out to be a dangerous mindset because instead of paying off my card every month, I would just pay the minimum and the balance just continued to go up and up and up. Welcome to the beginning of my previous debt issues. Instead of an every once in a while treat yourself day, my treat yourself day became the new normal. Income can be like Parkinson's law. If you don't know what that is, it's the adage that work expands so as to fill the time available for its completion. It's commonly used in reference to deadlines, but it can also be used in reference to our finances as well. Whatever our income is, our expenses will expand so as to fill the amount we are being paid. If we're always spending all of the money we earn, we'll never have any money that we can invest into income-producing assets. Lifestyle creep is probably the biggest wrench that can be thrown into anybody's ability to build wealth, and the most dangerous part about it is that we typically don't even notice it happening. So how do we avoid it? Well, I have a few tips that can help you keep and invest your hard-earned money. But before we jump into that, if you wouldn't mind hitting the like button for the YouTube algorithm, it would really help out the channel a ton. And also subscribe if you've been watching my videos and you've been really enjoying them. I love making these, I love talking about money, and if you've gained any kind of knowledge or have been really enjoying my videos and they've been helping you stay motivated and reaching your financial goals, it would be great if you could hit the subscribe button. Now, with that being said, let's jump into it. All right, so I know I've mentioned this one a lot on my channel, but it is very important to track your spending. I don't think I can iterate enough how important it is. After you track for a few months, it should give you a good idea of how much you're spending and how much you actually need so that you can make those adjustments in order to create some sort of a buffer between your spending and your savings. I personally do this manually via a spreadsheet, but you can also do this automatically with a service like Mint, which is free. If you don't know what Mint is, it's a free service that you connect all of your financial accounts to, your credit cards and your bank account, and it will track all of the spending that you have in your account and the income coming in, and all you have to do is log in and it will tell you your spending habits for you. The only thing you'll have to do is adjust the categories that you're doing your spending in every once in a while. I personally like tracking my spending manually because I find that it keeps me more up to date on what my spending is, and I find that I don't check Mint often enough, but you do you. Alright, so my second tip is to treat yourself, but treat yourself wisely. It's extremely easy to purchase something in the moment if you know you have the cash, or even if you don't have the cash but you have a credit card on you. If you find yourself wanting to buy something in the moment, take a step back, hold off, and think on it for a few days. Something I do when I get into those impulse buying moods is that I will take the item that I'm looking at and I will put it into my Amazon shopping cart and let it sit there for about a week. If I still feel that I need that item after it's been sitting there for about a week, I will go ahead and purchase it. If I don't still feel like I need that item, then I know I was only acting on impulse and then I can just delete it from my cart. This technique will help you focus on the things that you only really want and really need. All right, so tip number three is to make sure you're saving up for some fun. When you get a raise, take a portion of that additional income and sock it away in a separate fund. Say after you've been working somewhere for about a year or so, you get a 3% raise, take half of that, which would be about 1.5% in this hypothetical situation, and set it aside for some fun money. You could use this money for a dream destination vacation spot or for some big ticket item you've always wanted. Then you can take the other half of that raise and increase the amount you're investing with it. And that leads me to my next tip, make sure you are paying yourself. Make sure that as soon as you get your raise that you adjust the amount that you're paying yourself every month. Take some of those increased percentage points on your income and start applying it automatically through auto deposits into your investment accounts or your savings that you've set aside for your emergencies or other big investments. Making this an auto deposit is extremely important. If you automatically deposit your money into your investment accounts, you'll be less likely to notice that money being gone when you go in to check your bank balance. You've been living just fine on your current income, so setting aside that bonus income shouldn't be much of a problem. Trust me, the future you will be thanking the present you. All right, so the next tip on avoiding lifestyle creep is to make sure that you're writing down your financial goals. I've talked a lot in previous videos about how the little things add up. I think that there's gonna be a video popping up about right here if you wanna take a look at one of those previous videos. Writing down your financial goals will help you avoid spending money on the little things. You are actually 42% more likely to accomplish your goals if you write them down. Writing down your goals not only forces you to get clear on what exactly you want to accomplish, but doing so plays a part in motivating you to complete what is necessary for your success. This also goes for your financial goals. Every time you're tempted to spend money on anything non-essential, you'll be reminded of your goals and you'll consciously have to make the decision to postpone them. Make sure that when you write down your goals, you keep them in an area where you will see them often. That way you'll always have that constant reminder to stay on track and accomplish those big goals that you have set for yourself. Moving on to the next tip, make sure you upgrade your home gradually. It's easy for us to think that we need to upgrade everything as soon as we can afford it, especially if we're using hand-me-down or secondhand furniture. It's pretty exciting once you have the opportunity to upgrade that futon for a real bed. If you jump right into upgrading your furniture and most of your household items, you'll find that you've spent your raise very quickly. Take your time and set aside a budget for those big ticket items. You've gotten by with what you have for this long, so you can make a lot of it still work a little bit longer and then slowly upgrade things piece by piece. Don't forget, our parents and grandparents furnished their places over decades, so it's okay if we take some time getting our furniture and our home comforts built out. All right, and for my last tip, and this one's probably one of the most important ones, is make sure you surround yourself with financially like-minded people. You are the amalgamation of the five people you spend most of your time with. The people that you spend the most of your time with shape who you are. They determine which conversations dominate your attention. They affect which attitudes and behaviors you adopt. And eventually you start to think like they think and behave like they behave. If your buddies all get motorcycles and they decide they want to start a motorcycle gang, guess who's probably getting a motorcycle too? If you hang out with that neighbor that likes to go boating all the time, guess who's probably buying a boat soon? If your work friends all go out to lunch every day, then guess who else is going to be going out to lunch every day? It's you. Believe it or not, there's a lot of us out there who are frugally minded. Start making friends with similar financial goals as you, and your wallet will be thanking you in the long run. Also, once again, future you will thank you as well. So there you have it, 7 tips on how to avoid lifestyle creep. Believe me, most of us believe that more money is going to solve all of our problems. But the truth is, most of us end up spending as much, if not more, than we make every year, no matter how much we make. I hope these tips can help you avoid the lifestyle creep that tends to come with getting a raise, getting a promotion, or making more money. As always, if you've made it this far, please like, comment, and subscribe. Please show your support. It would really help out the channel a ton. If you don't want to track your spending manually, I'm going to have a link below to mint.com. It's not an affiliate link. It's just something that I think will be helpful for anyone who's looking to start tracking their spending and start to get a handle on their finances. One feature out of it that I really like is that it will automatically track your net worth, which I think is really cool. I like to log in about once a month and see what my net worth is at. If you'd like to get 2 free stocks, one of which can be valued up to $1,000, there's a link below to Webull. All you have to do is fund your account with $100 and those 2 stocks are yours. I've also got a link to M1 Finance below. That's the brokerage that I use for my stock investing. Make sure you check that one out. That one is extremely user-friendly and I really love using it. And I will talk to you next time. Peace.